Some guy just connected and joined in here. Yo. This guy just joined to a random server that no one should be able to join unless they downloaded the fake CSGO cheat software, ran it with accepting all the terms and conditions, which literally told him what's gonna happen step by step, plus got him joined onto the server where me and ScriptKid were waiting for them. Obviously, all this wouldn't be possible without ScriptKid, who set it up all by himself as he has plenty of experience in trolling cheaters in various games.
This is another tripwire punishment that causes the cheater to move extremely slowly for 20 seconds.
If you haven't seen his original videos, go have a look and subscribe to the man himself, who has a mission to make gaming world into a better place where there's less cheaters. I'll leave his links in the video description. Our game plan was simple. Instead of trolling cheaters, we wanted to talk with them slash understand them better. So we set up a website with a fake CSGO cheat called Project Neuron. This is how it looked. Design didn't have that much effort put into it, but if you scroll it through, it kinda looks legit. Now, if a person decides to try the cheat and downloads the software, before they could do anything, they needed to accept the terms and conditions, which had literally everything written into it, starting with the basics that cheating might get them permabanned, and ending with what will happen, so they will automatically join onto a community server where everything is recorded, etc. When the base was set plus ready to go, Script started Google Ads to drive traffic onto a website, and then the waiting game began. We spent way too many hours live on the server, waiting for cheaters to connect to it. And yes, we did play weird maps just to make the waiting a bit more fun. Yo, yo, yo.
He just left.
What just happened?
He has no mic. I tried to tell him that I couldn't leave the game and he just left.
When we got lucky with new guests on the server, we soon realized that most of the people that joined the server were obviously very confused, plus afraid to talk.
We can help you, man. If you speak, we can help you.
Yeah, we can help you out if you speak some English. Oh, he did it. He did it. Cabra, 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 what's up?
Hey, man. Hello.
Oh, he left.
Why am I stuck here?
Because you tried to cheat, Mr. Cheran.
Sorry. He left!
Some people even denied that they were cheating in the first place, although without touching the cheat, famous Project Neuron, they could never get onto this server. How did you end up here?
I don't know.
Do you know anything about the Project Neuron?
No.
How did you get here then?
Don't know.
Soon we realized that tens of hours of waiting just to get people to quickly connect and disconnect isn't that productive, plus doesn't get us to really talk with the cheaters. At that time, days had gone by, we had spent way too many hours on the server with no real interviews, but we also had more than 100 actual people who had joined with our server. So we tried to target some of the bravest people who had previously tried Project Neuron to get them onto a server again to talk about cheating. Also, mad respect to them for being brave enough to admit and talk about it. Firstly, the introduction.
I'm 14, I'm from Denmark, and my name is Mohamed.
How did you find out the Project Neuron?
I was talking with my friends and we were bored, so I was like, I'm just gonna download some cheats, and I just went on Google and searched on free CSGO cheats, and it came up.
Did he actually try to make sure Neuron is legit?
I'm gonna be 100% honest, no, I actually did not.
Okay. So you just found Neuron and you went all in?
Yeah, it's because I don't play that much competitive. Only play like Wingman and Hide and Seek.
Has he ever cheated before?
First time I ever cheated was like 207 days ago. Exactly, actually.
Oh, you're so accurate.
And it was because I was bored and I didn't actually play the game that much. So I just wanted to have some fun and try it.
Does he think cheating is fun?
Well, not for other players, but for the guy who cheated, it kind of is. But when I got the VEC banned, it wasn't that fun anymore.
Did he encounter any other cheaters?
No, maybe. I think actually one was my friend.
Does he still cheat?
No, not right now, because I can't find anything that actually works. But I don't think I want to cheat, because I don't really want to get banned again.
Has he ever cheated anywhere else, for example in real life?
Yeah, I have. Like, in a math test or something.
Why did he agree with a public interview?
Because, like, I've seen some of your YouTube videos, and I find it, like, interesting that, if you want to view like cheaters and hear what they have to say.
Ah, thanks, man. Thanks. Does he want to tell anything to the people watching this video?
Well, like, stop cheating and because you're ruining for, like, everybody else that plays the game.
Although the intimate moment in the end was interrupted by a phone, I hope you still got the point. Next up, a cool guy that we first met on train.
So, no, you can actually use my name. My friends who are playing CSGO found it quite funny that you added me and you busted me for cheating.
How did he find the Project Neuron?
I just searched for cheats and I don't know, I'm kind of unlucky with that. I searched for a GTA cheat once and it totally ripped my PC. So I think it was just some bad luck or good luck to find your cheating program.
When did he realize that this isn't a regular CSGO cheat?
When I connected to some kind of server.
And then you felt like, oh, this is prank.
Yeah, man, and I felt pretty ashamed of myself.
Next up, the good old age question.
I'm 24.
Why did he try to cheat?
Like, I'm pretty new to CSGO. Many of my friends played for years now. And I also wanted to get started. And when I entered like deathmatch and matchmaking, I saw that there are a lot of hackers and really got frustrated, man. I think it was trying to convince myself to just cheat in the beginning, to not have such problems with other hackers. But yeah, I don't know.
Has he ever cheated in some other games as well?
Yeah, but mostly like single player games. Back in time, I cheated in, I think, Crossfire. It was like an MMORPG, but something like a shooter more. And in GTA Online, I also cheated.
Did he enjoy playing with cheats?
Yeah, because you kind of like had better chances of getting good loot and something like that. It was like a one hit hack and something.
What did he want to achieve by cheating?
Show the other hackers that I can also hack. I think I thought of most people that that there are many hackers like in every match, and that really frustrated me, so I thought if they can do it, I can do it too.
What about his friends? Do they cheat as well?
My other friends, the ones you talked to.
Just for your info, I had to add some of his team friends to get a contact with him, so cheers to those friends.
They don't cheat because they think it's kind of dumb because it doesn't give you anything, and they're probably right, but as a beginner I think I thought differently.
People often talk about cheaters' mentality, that when you're okay with cheating, you do it everywhere. So has he ever cheated in real life?
Shit, man, that's a lot of stuff. Yeah, I guess in school, kind of like most people try to cheat at one time or another. So I had some exams where I cheated.
So did he learn anything from this experience?
Yeah, I think after that one, I really learned from the lesson, because they already told me that they don't really want to play with cheaters. So I won't change this behavior.
And finally, a space for the last words.
So I want to greet my friends Nabilak and Frexy, and I recommend all the cheaters that they don't download cheats and stop cheating.
It's hard to change the world, but whatever change starts from small steps. So I hope at least a couple of people learned their lesson with this project. Subscribe to the channel for more creative ideas in the future. Nice. And peace out.